All right, it was like a handsomeness convention. Chief Beck meeting James Brolin.
Comparing mustaches.
But, yeah. when the chief of police, James, endorses your mustache.
Yeah. I wonder if he pulled me over and he'd say, I'll let you go, buddy.
We're going to talk about Life in Pieces in a second. But before we do, it must be very gratifying to you. Look how well your son's doing.
I know. Isn't it great? And I mean, this picture has gone through the roof. Isn't it the biggest opening in history?
Yeah. Nice. Yeah.
And he's right now just landing in Paris. He's going to do a Paris, Berlin, Rome, you know, the whole thing. Yeah. So I'm sure he's kind of excited about
A lovely message from him to you.
What?
Here we go. Watch.
Come on.
What do you want to say to Dad? So I'll play this to him.
I talk to my dad almost every day. Mm-hmm. So talk to you later. How's that?
Fair enough. Do you guys have a conversation almost every day?
Actually, lately we have, you know, because he's got three pictures coming out, so he's been hard to get on the phone or to drop by and see him lately because, you know, he's worked 10 out of the last 12 months.
This is my favorite phrase as of late. Is it in the blood? Do you think that a little bit when you see him performing? That you have obviously an innate ability.
Yeah.
He obviously has an innate ability.
I learned from him. I call him in for advice. If I give him advice, I see a blank stare, of course. That father-son thing is there, you know? I started asking him for advice to see how that worked.
Wow.
Psychologically?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It worked really good. We're buddies now as long as he's the boss.
All right. Fair enough. A couple pictures here with a lady that we know. One thing that's interesting about Life in Pieces is Colin Hanks said this to me, Betsy Brandt has said it. It's like they're doing the show and then, oh, there's Barbra Streisand. And do you find that people, I mean, you see her every day.
Yeah.
But do people just go, oh, my God.
Like, oh, yeah, yeah. You know, like the first thing I ever did with her, I've always owned a pickup. Josh drives a pickup. I don't know if he came in here in his pickup. But the first thing I said when I met her is we're going on vacation.
Uh-huh.
And she said, in that? I said, yeah, brand new. Let's go.
Right.
So we did the five Indian states around Lake Powell, all the way Montana, Wyoming.
Beautiful.
And she got out at every truck stop and went, wow, look at this stuff. This is so. Anyway, to answer your question, if anybody's spotted her, we now are really good at moving on quickly.
Okay,
you know?
I see.
In the meantime, I said, wear this hat. No, I'm not wearing that hat. It doesn't look good.
Right.
So you weren't intimidated when you first met Barbra Streisand. You just said, get in the pickup truck. We're going on vacation.
No.
Yeah.
No, it was appreciation, if anything. She was very honest with me from the get-go.
Aww.
I won't tell you what it was, but I went, wow, somebody tells the truth around here. I love this, you know?
Yeah.
There's no games with her. It's pretty straightforward.
Got to run this piece of tape. You have been in my household forever. And when Marcus Welby, MD, was the big ABC hit, and Dr. Stephen Kiley would come on, my mother would say, shh, my boyfriend's on TV.
Oh, that's cute.
Do you remember that show?
Well, we were number one by the sixth show, and I won the Emmy for the pilot.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't know how, but I think if I remember, I had some Visine. Put them in my eyes, and then I'd say, okay, ready. and I read this letter, as I remember, and got me the Emmy.
Oh, wow.
Great trick.
There you go. Let's talk about Life in Pieces. You say that the best part is this call sheet with 11 names on it, and you just love going to work.
Everybody in our cast is so delicious. Mm. I love it. And several of them have been here, you told me, Sam. And you know how delightful they are. They're really delightful. Every day going to work, there's always a bad seed, you
right.
know?
Right.
Yeah.
Not here. Not here. And I'm on the first stage I ever worked out in 1960. I did an episode of Bus Stop, which was an old Marilyn Monroe movie made into a series. And that was in 1960 on the 1928 Will Rogers stage. And I'm back there. It feels like an old worn-in shoe.
Wow.
It's so great to go to work and not in a brand new plastic You know,
she looks around here. Right. We get it. Like, right.
Well, actually, I can't see the walls.
Right.
No,
I think they're real.
Tainted.
Right, right.
They're
old-timey. They are. All right. Yeah. I got to ask you this. Prior to you sitting here, Henry, the most handsome amongst us on the desk.
Yes.
But
definitely.
But you're way better looking than Henry. Wait.
That and $5 will get you a Starbucks.
But is there a secret? Is it being relaxed or clean living or what is it?
Actually, about three and a half years ago, I'm looking in the mirror going, oh, man, it's all over now, you know. And I met, I got an invitation from Laird Hamilton to come up to his pool and work out.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on up. And I started working out. He showed me, and Gabby Reese showed me all the ways to get your stuff back.
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah. And it's working. And now I do underwater exercises with the weights underwater at home.
Uh-huh.
You know, the first thing he does is give you 20 pounds in each hand, put you 13 feet under, and say, okay, now breathe.
Okay,
you
want
to breathe, you get to the top 20 times.
Wow.
And plus whatever products he's selling. And I'm just told anything Laird does, I'll do.
All right.
Because look at it.
Look at it.
Yeah.
Look at you.
You're right.
Would Barbara say you've got your stuff back?
What?
Or it never left.
Or never left.
Yeah, I think so. We are better than ever. We're better than that first day 20 years
ago. Oh,
yeah.
This has just been the most charming thing ever. I got to tell you, Life in Pieces is tonight at 9:30. So funny on CBS. We got some tickets to the Ohana Festival. We jump back. James Brolin, nice
to
see you.
Thank you, James.
I want a ticket.
There you go.